If you're making a film, it doesn't tax the camera more to film a crowd scene than it does to film a close-up of an actor. But in comics, every single panel is going to be drawn by an artist. Your artist is a rare and precious resource who should not be overtaxed, because ideally you would like to make more books with them in the future, and they're no good to you if they're dead. The truth is, no two writers approach writing comics the same. A lot of people vary their approach dependent on the project and the artist they're working with. But the challenge remains. How much can you fit in a graphic novel? This video isn't about how to write for comics. It's just about how to think like an artist when you're approaching the page. Thing number one, action. The challenge with comics is that you can really only show one clear action per panel. You could have a lot of complicated business going on in the background, but it's always going to be a difficulty to make sure that your reader understands precisely what is going on. These are some opening storyboards from Batman the Animated Series. If you lose any one of these frames, it becomes unclear what's going on in the action. Ask yourself, how many actions are taking place per panel, and does every action have a setup and a follow-through? Also watch out for having more than one action occurring simultaneously in a single panel. Thing number two, emotion. If you've ever watched actors, you understand that a good scene is dependent on characters not just saying all of their lines in quick succession with no pause for breathing room. Exactly the same thing applies in comics. Let's take a look at a page from Cyril Pedrosa's book, Three Shadows. This page is a masterclass in emotional storytelling. There are six panels, and every single one of them serves a particular purpose to further the complex emotional symphony of the scene. Make sure to leave lots of breathing room for your characters to interact and possibly experience time dilation through larger panels or lots of small panels together, but something that will convey that there is real pathos going on here. Thing number three, rhythm. When I talk about rhythm, what I mean is the relationship between density and spaciousness. Here's an example from This Was Our Pact by Ryan Andrews. In this scene, the protagonists are swimming in the ocean at night. Here's the compression, but then on the following page, beautiful. Ask yourself, how fast is time moving for my characters? And what pace do I want the reader to move at? Those two numbers might not be the same. They also might not be numbers. Thing number four, clarity. Here's a double page spread from Delilah, Dirk, and the Pillars of Hercules. There is so much going on here, but the coloring and layout make it clear that the most important panel is this one right here. All these other panels do advance the story in their own way, but having that sense of clarity around what's most important allows Tony to draw the eye with this diagonal sweep of dialogue to create a full impact for this moment of the story. Ask yourself, what is the most important thing to communicate in this scene? Your artist may be able to make some of these decisions for you, but if, as a writer, you're coming from a background of understanding that emphasis, it's going to make both of your jobs a lot easier. Finally, I want to leave you with some words of encouragement. Everybody struggles with this. It is hard. There are so many variables in comics, and it can be a real challenge to make sure that you're bringing all of them together onto the page to make for clear storytelling. Your job as a writer isn't necessarily to anticipate every single place where an artist might need your help in figuring out how the panel layout is going to go, or the compression or distortion of time. But you do want to make sure that in your working relationship, you understand how much leeway to give your artist so they can really make the beats sing and bring your characters to life. That's what a real working relationship is all about. If you'd like to see me walk through step by step how I applied this feedback to a specific page from our script and a lot more examples, you can head over to my Patreon at patreon.com/LucyBellwood to learn more. Thanks for watching!